facial reconstructive surgery. I hope I look better than I normally look. And I got this new face. My son is watching. It's for you. I would never recommend that she comes on a low rent show like this, but she said I gotta do it. I wanna do it. My sister. Moon.
Hi.
Hi, how are you? do I look different after the reconstructive facial surgery mask? To you?
I accept you no matter how you look.
So this mask, I'm wearing this. I know I invited you to see Ghost the other night, right?
I couldn't attend.
You couldn't go. Arrow went. Arrow is 7. And it was an unbelievable night of music, right? And we couldn't wait in line to get this thing. But, you know, Gwendolyn...
Wait, was that their merch? That's their merch, that thing?
Yeah. So after the show... You can't get these during the show or before the show. You have to wait till after the show, and then these are available. So if you're a Ghost fan, you might have collected the different.
How often do they change the masks? And is it?
I guess from tour to tour, right? Is that true?
I would assume so.
Yeah.
What's this tour called?
You know, I don't know. I just think it's you just go to Ghost, and it is it's.
It's called indoctrinating your children into the Satanic Church tour.
It was a powerful night of pop music, pop rock music.
But they're not really Satanists. They just like to sing about that stuff, right?
You mean Papa?
Yeah, Papa, exactly.
Yeah, Papa is he's a dark mummy, ghoul, pope.
I think if you were to put it in Scientology terms, he's like an OT6 Satanist.
Huh.
What does that mean? Don't have those references? Can you say
he's
it
a Satanist
layman?
To the sixth level.
Okay, but to a layman, what is that? How could you say it like with cereal?
Put in some time.
Oh, well, let's talk about it in other relatable terms.
Yeah.
Like in hot sauce terms, right?
Does he have a Nero?
There's Tapatio. Okay. There's Tapatio at the bottom.
Yeah.
Then there's Cholula at the top. And then like a lot in the middle.
What? Cholula's not spice, on spice level, not in flavor.
I'm talking about flavor.
No, it'd be like ghost pepper hot.
El Yucateco, the yellow stuff. That's number one.
What? Just culinary knowledge did you just drop on
us? Is
that
New Mexico stuff?
It's not. It's Los Angeles, Ralph's and Vaughn's stuff. El Yucateco, ladies and gentlemen, okay. Playing along at home.
This thing is hot.
Yeah,
okay?
You could take it off.
So Gwen, she was kind enough to actually get this for Arrow. So Arrow, if you're watching, congratulations.
He did well the other night, by the way, as far as merch went.
Uncle Brando, right?
Not just me.
He takes me aside. Moon, it's something you would do, right? He takes me aside and he's like, hey, it's okay. Honestly, as I'm reflecting back on the memory, it was kind of like creepy guy in a van kind of a move.
Well, that's
where
my
you walked
vibe.
Over to me and you were like, hey, is it okay if I buy your son a shirt? But I'm like, why are you whispering? He can't fucking hear you. Everyone's screaming, ghost, ghost, ghost outside. Is that okay? I would like to be able to buy him his first ghost shirt. And then you were kind of thwarted by
Gigi.
she went out and she got him like the rosaries. They sell like these, you know, awesome ghost rosaries. The whole thing. He was kitted out.
Why did you whisper it? I mean, and why did you ask for permission? And I approve, but I'm just curious about the thinking there.
You've known me for a long time.
Yeah.
I'm a rule follower.
But where did you get
to
the,
a fault?
But
I
where
asked
did you
for
get
permission.
The rule about ask the parent if you can buy the thing? Where did you get that?
I love that we're talking about parenting because you know we were discussing, what would be hilarious probably to only you and I, right?
Yeah.
But maybe we should do like a round table conversation where we just it's almost like a therapy session. Where we talk about probably overly personal stuff, and I think that you and I have a similar way of dealing with emotions. Where
go to the comedy.
You go to the comedy.
Yep.
But with graphic detail.
Yep. Right? Yep. Make it uncomfortable and make it funny.
Okay. So can you make it uncomfortable and make it funny and just talk about maybe how you and Brando first met? Because I think we've talked about the how long you've known each other, right?
Yeah, but I mean, why? What does that have to do with parenting?
Because I'm a child. I'm a 56-year-old child.
There's that.
Okay.
Who needs a lot of parenting.
Are you just staring at your social feed the entire time?
No, I actually was looking at...
What the fuck is that? Okay, are you going to join the show?
I am, but here's the thing. I was looking for more material to discuss. So you were talking about the Satanist band.
Is this your comedy crib notes that you're checking out right now?
I am. These are my... these are my...
You came prepared for this show?
I'm just trying to get the letters to make the anagram right now. I can't get it fast enough. The point is, my only Satan interactions are with the amazing documentary Hail Satan by Penny Lane. And that's why I was asking you if that guy's a real Satanist, because the tenets of Satanism, mm-hmm. per this particular Satanist sect,
yeah.
If you read those tenets, you'd be like, oh, I am definitely on board with Satan. Because normally I'm not on board with Satan.
I don't know if I am or not.
So I'm
first blush, I'm gonna go hard pass, but uh-huh. mm-hmm. maybe if you go down this list, maybe.
Well, that's what I was trying to find, the satanic the checklist. I was trying to find their.
Are you a Satanist? These are if you answer yes to this, then you're a Satanist.
Yeah.
For that?
Well, if you look up what their beliefs are and their value system. So, but mm-hmm. I can't find it fast enough. Do you have a stat?
I know number one is, do you like having a good time?
That is not it.
Yes, it is.
No, it isn't.
Okay. Absolutely.
I just want to say, if people want to actually call in, if you are familiar with the tenets of, I guess, Satanism and want to have
Lucian Greaves, Lucian, how you say his name? Lucian? How do you say it?
You could probably say it both ways.
Well, if
you're
can.
Like
Lucian.
So if you were watching like that werewolf movie with what's her name? Who's
Christina Ricci.
Yes, she'd made that bad werewolf movie. Bitten or something like that. Feral. I don't know what the movie was called. Okay. Not that one. Yes. And she was a werewolf in that movie. No, the Underworld franchise. I think Lucian was like one of the main vampire baddies. That's, and then right. Lucian, there's lots of people named Lucian. But if you want to call and speak to us about your love of the Dark Lord, or talk to Moon about it, 855-601-ROCK. 855-601-ROCK. 855-601-7625. Gwen is on the horn. And Gotti, Naughty Gotti, our director, do you know the top three things that you let someone know if you're a Satanist? Do you have it seems like something you would know. The audience can't hear you when you shake your head. I can see you shaking your head, but no one knows if that's actually an answer.
No.
I know what they are. Number one, do you like to have a good time?
It is not.
Number
that.
Two, do you know that you deserve all the riches that the earth has to offer you? That's number two.
Okay, well, that sounds, I feel like I deserve the riches that the earth has to offer, because isn't that like burritos and if I was a pirate,
yes,
okay,
which you kind of are,
and I had a treasure map, mm-hmm. I would hope mm-hmm. that when I like sailed the seven seas and got to a secret place, that and I had my own diamond encrusted shovel and my big feather and my really awesome pirate hat, I would dig and dig and dig. And I would find a chest of freshly made burritos, and that would be, oh God, like, but like the ground beef, like I don't want a like Taco Bell style. I want like a step up from there.
Like a cactus on vine level burrito.
Like a Henry's Tacos in the Valley, but with avocado. Like they don't have guac.
Okay, found them.
Oh,
there you go.
There are seven.
Wait, what? Where is this? Where did you find it?
This is the Satanic Temple, satanictemple.com. These are the tenets of Satanism, according to Lucian Greaves.
Okay, this is what I'm excited about.
Yeah.
All things being tracked.
Yeah.
Right? Your search history now.
Mm-hmm.
Just alerted the CIA to your location.
Yeah. This is great. Okay.
Well,
lose my number. Okay, keep going.
One,
mm-hmm.
one should strive to act with compassion and empathy toward all creatures in accordance with reason.
To indoctrinate them into your dark service?
You added that.
Wait, hold on.
Two.
Wait, so this is like be kind to animals and people.
Yeah.
Okay. All right.
Two. All right. The struggle for justice is an ongoing and necessary pursuit that should prevail over laws and institutions.
Okay. Right.
Which sees Christian religious rules as dumb.
But this just feels like basically like if you're going to go to USC to become one of the great entertainment lawyers, this is like
number three.
Basic.
One's body is inviolable. How do you say that?
Inviolable?
Inviolable.
Inviolable?
Inviolable. How do you pronounce that? Inviolable. Can't be violated. Subject to one's own will alone.
Mm. Okay.
You're in charge of your body. Your body, your rules.
Is that what that says?
That's number three.
Okay. All right.
Inviolable.
All right, Captain Cocktail, you down with the...
That's me trying to say it sober.
Is your body inviolable? Right, I don't know if you can hear him.
Is it a satanic temple?
He says his body is a satanic temple.
Okay, number four. Mm-hmm. The freedoms of others should be respected, including the freedom to offend. To willfully and unjustly encroach upon the freedoms of another is to forego one's own.
Can I just say something? Like, yeah. As you were talking, it went from like I'm listening, and then it just became words.
Okay, well.
Ca-caw! Just became like white noise.
There is.
And I think I'm a good listener. Do you think I'm a good listener, or?
Depends on if the person's useful to you.
Oh,
okay. No, I think you are
comedy,
a good listener.
Comedy crib notes, okay. Right? A little truth, little something there.
That was a
nice little cobra strike.
Yep. What would you do to a young Rick? We like to talk about Rick Zappa on this show a lot. What were some of your tactics along that line?
No, I think that was revenge from when you told me that I was boring.
Oh,
when did I say that?
A lot when you were little.
Well, I stand by that, I guess.
I know.
Because
I don't disagree.
Kids are, that's truth serum. So, like, how old are we talking?
Television actor Amit Zappa.
Seven, but it still hurt.
Oh, yeah. That's my son is seven, you know, Arrow, as you know.
Yeah.
He's got wisdom. He's got real truth. He right. calls it like he sees it. So
exactly.
if you know, I got to say he and I are probably pretty similar. So, maybe we can ask Arrow at some point if he thinks you're boring too. Maybe he'll tell you the truth that you are.
Number five, mm-hmm. beliefs should conform to one's best scientific understanding of the world. One should take care never to distort scientific facts to fit one's beliefs. Agree or disagree?
I feel like someone put this list together and just put this down
This is what they believe. This is Satanism. This is the good Satanism. I'm going to keep going. Number six.
This feels weird.
I know this to be true.
I know.
True.
I was trembling in the when they were reading them because I was like, I didn't know I was a
trembling
Satanist.
in a bathtub with a single light dangling like this, and you're like,
yes, and I have a portable one
like that.
I have a
like
portable bathtub and a portable light. Yeah.
Okay.
Because I was in a theater, but I still was trembling. Just
you
as
were in
you
a
described.
Bad music video. In the '90s.
Yep. And then there was a wind machine. My hair looked great.
Okay, because it's all ponytails and I don't know the difference between your ponytails or your necklaces. I feel like they could be the same thing.
They're pony necklaces.
How many, like, are you a pony puss? Because you have like...
Yeah.
Is that a thing?
To be a pony puss?
A ponoctopus?
Starting today it is, yeah.
Yeah, okay, keep going. Keep going on this
Number
list.
Six, people are fallible. If one makes a mistake, one should do one's best to rectify it and resolve any harm that may have been caused.
Okay.
Number seven, mm-hmm. last one. Every tenet is a guiding principle designed to inspire nobility in action and thought. The spirit of compassion, wisdom, and justice should always prevail over the written or spoken word.
Okay, so are you a Satanist?
By this list of yes.
Yeah,
I think everybody. Hopefully, everyone at the table is.
I'm going to go to the Burning Man list right now too. Those are amazing too.
Oh wait, there's a.
Burning Man has tenets too.
So wait, this is just what this is on some
side. I love looking up tenets.
This is frogwash, right?
What do you mean?
Is that really, I don't know that. There's a lot of common sense in that.
Yes,
a ton of it.
That's right.
But I don't know if that's actually. That can't possibly be.
See that documentary and have your. your reality shaped a little bit differently. Just, you know, expanded.
Are the Burning Man tenants the same thing? It's like the same list, except that you have to be on hallucinogens.
No, and that's not the Burning Man. The spirit of Burning Man is it's a gifting economy.
First of all, I'm impressionable. You understand this? You are you basically raised me. Mm-hmm. So as you're telling me these things, it's going in.
Mm-hmm. Good.
Right. Then there's like caw caw caw. So
right.
You know, that's my ADD brain. But some of it's actually getting in there. So if you said, you know. Fire! Run! I'm gonna do that.
Mm-hmm. That actually did happen with our sister Diva.
Yeah, that was mean. That's your cruel mean.
And that was that. I didn't realize how much she trusted me, and I broke it that day.
Until you
broke
it
when I said run. Yeah, we thought it was funny, and then
no. So you thought it was funny
because I did.
Because then you lump everyone. You shared the blame just then.
Oh, I'm sorry. Were you not laughing? Because you were laughing.
Yeah, but I didn't.
Because laughter usually.
Okay. I didn't
laughter
do
usually
it.
Indicates I think it's funny too.
Yeah, but what I'm trying to get at is that you broke the trust in a different way. So I'm saying I failed her differently than you failed her that day in a huge way.
That's true. And
responsible
and still trying to win the trust back. Not happening today. Today it's not back yet. That's okay.
But I love that you have that as a Satanist, your Satan hope. That you're going to be able to get that trust.
First
back.
Of all, I'm not a Satanist, but if I'm just saying, do the ghost guys, are they, is this, are they in alignment? With
I have no
beliefs?
Idea. As far as I know, it's a comedy routine.
What kind
routine.
Of a fan are you?
I see them as, I have some lists of like, are you in the corner of my, in my peripheral vision, well, handsome British guy has got a very special outfit he's going to unveil later on and maybe talk to us about why he's wearing it. But where are we? Should we take a commercial break for a second?
We don't even have drinks.
I know, right? We got to get Captain Cocktail over. He made you a special drink, Moon.
Oh, I didn't try it.
It's a celebration.
Great.
Let's take a quick commercial break. When we come back, I love where this show is going. We'll play some more music. We'll talk about so many things. Again, if you feel like giving us a call, it is Rocktails, 855-601-7625. Lines are open. You get to meet Roz. Roz is on the horn.
Roz from New York.
Yeah.
Steve Jones. I used to play guitar with a band called the Sex Pistols. A good friend of mine, Sid Vicious, died from drugs. I nearly died from drugs. Drugs suck.
Monday on Buck Rogers.
In our next episode, Princess Ardala returns with a diabolical scheme to bring the Earth to its knees and Buck Rogers to the altar.
They're going to use that weapon to extort us.
I want Buck Rogers.
Destroy it, now.
Our puzzles have no effect.
Talk about shotgun weddings.
Monday at 6 on Channel 13.
Music talk over ice. Very nice. This is Rocktails with Amit Zappa.
And
we're back. And we're back. It's Rock Tales with Ahmed Zappa.
The Buck radiation for a DuckTales.
Is it
a DT? Why is it called a DA?
I think it was called a DA. That's just what I remember it being called. But it was a DuckTale haircut that was a Stray Cats, like the pompadour thing. So I was obsessed with Brian Setzer for a while. Yeah. And the Stray Cats. And
do you know what we do on the show?
You listen to music and talk about
music? We have cocktails.
Uh-huh.
And we listen to music.
Great.
And we have a bartender,
mm-hmm.
right? Who, by the way, Captain Cocktail. He's made, in honor of you, made some very special cocktails, which he does most shows when he's not traveling, when he's not on the Nile, and I'm not even joking, when he's not in Cairo, when he's not opening a new bar, when he's not inventing some new liqueur for fucking hipsters. He, right, graces us with his time and energy and love, mostly because it's convenient, because, you know, he lives in the neighborhood and maybe this is a good time to him. But Captain Cocktail, the leader in you know, how many, I mean, you're the guy who ghostwrites like cocktail books for other celebrity bartenders. I mean, he's so dialed in, Captain Cocktail. I think he's gonna give us some cocktails. Normally we have you kind of explain everything, but today, because Moon's here, maybe just give us something delicious. And
I still want to know what it is. Can he say it beside me? Can he just share my mic and tell me about it?
Like he should like whisper into your yeah. ear, like Brandon.
Can I give everybody saying, this cocktail?
Yeah.
Okay, so I'm seeing, what is this? This is like a little piece of clementine. What is that?
It's a cutie.
It's a cutie. And then there's lime in there. And the color is, it's a sort of a murky apricot color. What's in there?
It's, you've tasted this.
How do you know I've tasted it? Is it semen?
Yeah.
Wow.
Because semen tastes different depending on the person.
If you grew up in L.A., you've had this.
But that's why it still could be.
Why do you think I have? Why do you think?
Wait, cheers, everybody.
Yeah,
wait,
okay, I'll cheer, but what is it?
As there's someone who's never tasted semen, can you taste that and tell me if that is?
What do you mean you've never tasted your own body fluids?
No.
What? What kind of a scientist are you?
Not that kind of a scientist. Okay.
That's really good. Is my mic on? I don't think it's on. A chiggity chick.
I really don't know what that is. What am I drinking? That's a margarita? It doesn't.
It's that fucking delicious is what's happening.
I didn't recognize its margarita-ness.
Are you back on, Brando?
I don't think I am. No, I am not.
It's good. It's yummy. Okay.
Something's happening with Brando's mic.
So but, margaritas, do you like it? Margaritas are the upper drinks, right? Most drinks are downer drinks, but margarita as a spirit, is it a spirit?
You know no one can hear him, right? You're talking to the one guy that you're going to have to translate. So... as far as I know, tequila, at least in my family, right?
Mm-hmm. It's truth serum.
Yes, and mm-hmm. it gets me fired up.
Yeah, it's an upper. It
gets me fired up to take a nap.
Really? Like coffee?
I might be like, woo! And then like, hey guys, I'm going to go watch, you know, I don't know, Chud 2. Not even the Ridge.
I don't know. I never saw Chud.
You've never seen Chud?
Who's in Chud?
You've never seen Chud.
I don't think I've seen Chud.
Cannibalistic humanoid underground dwellers.
No.
Chemical hazard urban disposal.
Nope.
Chud.
I'm hearing it, but I'm. It's not.
Did we grow up in the same house?
For a time. There was a Venn diagram over.
Okay. Well, let's talk about this. So if...
Now my mic is going in and out. Oh, okay. Yeah, so I took the first hit in the parenting world.
So as I was growing up,
yeah.
Being able to rent videos and things was like really came into power, right?
Mm-hmm.
But there were still videos being played in the house. So when I could go and let's say rent American Ninja, you had already seen just some of the kind of family movies. So what movies might those have been that you watched?
When I was growing up in the house, mm-hmm. our father would bring reel-to-reels
right.
of Betty Boop, Felix the Cat.
Okay.
And then whatever weird...
Can you name... Can you sing the Felix the Cat theme song?
I can, but I choose not to.
Felix the Cat. The wonderful cat. You'll laugh so hard, your sides will ache, your heart will go pitter-pat. Watching Felix, the wonderful cat.
Yep. Mm-hmm. That's right.
Yeah. Right?
And so we would see those.
Nailed it, right?
You nailed it.
So I learned that through osmosis. Do you remember Vavoom?
Yes.
Do you remember Vavoom, Brando?
I don't remember Vavoom.
But before cartoons and movies and things of that nature, I got to see all of the dirty cartoon magazines laying around.
So I thought
Viper.
Viper.
The Viper. I think it was a raping shadow of some sort.
Wait, do you remember? Oh, that sounds really good.
It was. I'll say it was.
And
too
you're not
much.
A Satanist. You were turned onto that, and you're somehow not a Satanist.
No, it turned me off actually to that world. Yeah, yeah, I was like, I'm gonna look for a turtleneck bathing
suit. Is that
suit.
A thing? Is because it sounded like you said it with such confidence. You're like, it was a raping shadow.
Yeah.
Is that a phrase that I'm unaware of?
That's just what my recollection was. There was a lot of R. Crumb.
What about remember the movie The Entity with Barbara Hershey?
I grew up with a fear of pinheads because Gail told me that they bite your ankles.
Pinheads.
And then we had a lot of books around about freaks, like carnival freaks.
Okay, Tricky Dicky,
yeah.
did you, any of this feeling like a reminder of your childhood, like a warm hug or no?
It's exactly like my childhood. I've always told you that. Your childhood and my childhood, exactly the same.
Fear of pinheads, ankle biting?
Yeah.
Ankle biting pinheads.
All of it.
Brando?
I grew up in a house, likewise, where Swedish porn was just all over the place in every house. Yeah.
And
in every room. Every
ankle biting pinheads?
Pinheads, same thing. My mom was like, Zippy the pinhead. Stay the fuck away from
him. He'll bite your ankles.
Number one.
Right.
Here's some Swedish porn.
Mm-hmm.
Do you want to watch Felix the Cat later on? Absolutely.
Cool. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
If my son is watching, mommy can explain all of this to you right now. Okay. So
I'm delighted by this.
By what?
Because you know, I'm never at a loss for words, but I'm really kind of feeling the power of the brother and sister thing. That is happening right now, right in front of me. I'm having an out of body experience right now.
Let me say something.
This is very special for me. I'm almost emotional.
You're going to be jealous of this fact. Okay.
Uh-huh.
So, there was a moment where, honestly, a too long period of time where, you know, we didn't have the best communication, right? And we work on this. And this is why when we were saying earlier in the show, I was like, oh my God, it would be really funny to just share different points of view. Because our ages are so far apart. Our parents, right? It's like we had different kinds of parenting.
Yes, you did.
Right?
Well,
of course we did.
Absolutely did.
So that's kind of comical to us, but we've been spending a lot of time at Ernie's Taco House, right? Do you want to talk?
But before that, though, Amit, you and I did spend a lot of time. We were fitness people together. You and I
I don't remember that.
What are you talking about? We would
Amit was a fitness person?
Barry's Boot Camp.
Yeah.
Not
Barry's.
Riverside.
No, it wasn't Barry's. It was Barry's. Another.
Shame on you.
It was another boot camp. It was on the top floor of a bank
of
building.
A bank. Yeah.
I
was ripped.
You guys took me to that place, and the guy punched me. Do you remember that?
You weren't working hard enough.
No, it was the Chase.
And by the way,
no. It was the Chase Bank building on Riverside and Laurel Canyon. And the guy punched me.
Jay.
Yeah.
Jay punched me.
Were you working hard enough? Were you sweating?
No, I was
not taking it seriously?
I was exercising.
Okay.
Well, and I was.
Yeah.
Wow.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, so we would do all kinds of.
That's the takeaway. Like we had different, like, an age difference and.
No, you were. I was just saying that there were many times where we had overlaps of, I think lots of fun times. We had.
A few years of bad communication, but otherwise we hung out all the time. Am I remembering this wrong or something?
That's how I remember it. And then remember when we both were the only family members that went to therapy? That was fun, independently and together.
Yeah.
Which moon friend
did
Rick Zappa dislike the most and like the most? Let's start with like the most.
Like as a friend or in the hotness?
I think in the hotness thing.
Oh, on the hotness thing?
Yeah, on the hotness
Robin
thing.
Robin Friedman.
Oh, my God. All right, well, Fuck, my son is watching.
There's no other answer.
Shayna called me.
Blonde.
Okay, hold on. Shayna, this is where you turn this off.
Canadian.
So,
Robin Friedman. Okay. Valley or Hollywood side?
Valley. Well,
Valley.
No, maybe not quite, though. I mean, like, border.
That's true.
Depending. Because mm-hmm. it was still 2 and 3.
Mm-hmm.
You know,
yep.
Until it became 8-1-8. But here's what I'll say. Moon has probably just done Chips.
Okay. Yes.
All right. It was fucking awesome.
It really was.
This is when Poncherello signed that. Best time of my life.
Okay. Visiting the set.
No, hold on. Let me just back to back. She does Chips. Then she's on Elvira, Mistress of the Dark. I still have those autographed pictures. No one gets me more excited than Elvira. I just love the whole oeuvre of a vampire zombie monster lady that then shows you other monster movies.
Hosts
whatever
be monster movies.
That's the
yeah.
best. That's the best job yeah. of all time. Anyways, love her. So Moon
Cassandra
of course,
Peterson.
Yeah, has Valley Girl comes out. A lot of activity, you know, a lot of fun things happening in the house. And yeah, Robin would come over. It was, you know, you're 14. It's fun to be, a teenager for you. I mean, I don't want to speak for you. Maybe you can talk to it.
No, it was not fun.
Okay, well, let's...
But that's a longer story. No, let's just keep it fun
no,
today.
No, let's talk about that. But so Moon has this big sleepover, right?
On the hickey.
To put it into context...
Does everyone have a family hickey?
No, to put it into context, you at this time, yeah. right... You are essentially a year older than, a year and a half older than my daughter.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Yeah.
So imagine that's like my daughter a year from now having a pop song that's played everywhere, right? And then and as a teenager, just wanting to have your friends over and have a sleepover party, mm-hmm. right?
Yeah.
Pizza, right? You don't want your
well. We had submarine sandwiches and we had orange sherbet.
Yeah, and then you have your 7-year-old brother,
yeah,
right, who's just watched because you think it's funny and it becomes family viewing that you have your song out, Valley Girl,
mm-hmm.
and maybe it was Vivid Entertainment or the equivalent of that time period Uh-oh. Made Valley Girls,
oh no,
the porno, and you watch that as a child, and I just remember the. It was an ironing board where I think am I remembering this right? The man lays down and the woman gets on top and she says, I'm humping you. Right?
Wait.
Wait, hold on.
This is a Valley Girl porn spinoff that
you remember that, right?
Nope, but I'm listening.
Okay, so wait. Was this not you silently telling me, hey, why don't you tell the story why you like Robin so much? Because do you remember?
I just mentioned Robin, but I love where this is going.
Okay, well.
Don't stop.
Okay, so you had a sleepover.
Yeah.
And you don't remember me coming into the sleepover?
And
after
you climbed into a pillowcase.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And you said, I'm going to hump you.
Yeah, because I had just seen it.
Right. So you were just saying dialogue. I didn't have the prior reference. I just heard you saying it for the first
time.
You
know, what you're saying is this is why we need to do a show about family stuff is that you blacked out that part. For me, I was like, wait, what do humans do? That looks awesome. And by the way, your friend Robin, if I'm just with the older people and I climbed on top of her after watching your sleepover because you all watched that movie.
I feel like I walked out because I don't remember any of the porn you're describing. But what I remember was you were in a sleeping bag and it was like a two-legged race or something.
I was like,
you were just a solo artist in the sleeping bag in the pillowcase that was, it came up to your chest. So tiny.
I was tiny. It was also a big pillowcase. But what was I doing in that pillowcase? Because I remember this.
It was a rubbing fest.
No. Nope. Nope.
You were rubbing my friend.
I did this. I go, no.
You're like a Tigger.
Yes, and mm-hmm. this is what I did.
A rubbing Tigger.
Because I might
it's normal. It's natural. It's
not
bad.
I might forget a bunch of things. Mm-hmm. But maybe this will trigger their actual what actually happened. And okay. Maybe you have her number. Maybe I should apologize. Maybe my 7-year old self should apologize to your friend. But this is what I did. I go, hey, Robin, touch right here. And she's like, okay, because I'm 7. Maybe she thinks she's going to tickle me or something. Mm-hmm. And she grabbed my erect penis. And I was like, yeah. Cheers, yeah. Robin. You're welcome.
I just heard someone say Jesus. Yes. Start with Satan. We're back with Jesus.
I can see that as if it happened yesterday.
Wait, what did I do with my Captain Cocktails? I was like, that's not Captain Cocktails drink.
By the way, at that same
Captain
age.
Captain Cocktail, thank you. I didn't thank you. It's delicious. This is a really
this
good
truth serum is working. Thank you. Mm-hmm. No, what I also remember at that age was you said, Moon, I'm going to pee on you. And I was like, okay. And then you did. And I was like, stop that.
Yeah. Because
yeah, same age, same time.
But that was in Santa Barbara?
No, that was in the kitchen.
Yeah, it gets rough.
Yeah. Thanks, Ian. Thanks for understanding. Ian, do you think I owe my sister an apology for my behavior as a child?
I have no idea.
Thanks,
Ian. Ian, do you sympathize with Moon, though? It was hard. It's hard being the oldest child in a house. It's hard being the oldest child of a house filled with like dynamic like children. You like trains. Yeah.
Okay.
Isn't it hard being number one? Because I was number one. You're number one. Isn't it? You go through the
I think
most.
You're still number one.
First.
Thank
you're
you.
Number one in my eyes.
I really appreciate
and
that.
In my heart.
I think what's challenging about it with our parents, because I can't speak for other families, but in growing up as number one in this family, it was Gail, anyway, because Frank was away for most of it. Gail was like, well, that doesn't seem to be working. Never mind that. I'll try something different with 2 through 4.
Yeah, that feels actually right.
Yeah.
But what's weird, mm-hmm. I actually think that, let's really talk about that for 1 second. Mm-hmm. Because I do think that was a methodical choice of like, yeah, no, let's try this. And it's like, abort that mission. And then we're going to put a whole new kind of set of rules and understandings. And that must have been challenging mm-hmm. for,
yeah.
Do you think it was challenging for you?
I sure do.
Do you have one example that you like to share with, you know, Brando and Tricky Dicky? Most challenging.
See. Let me see what Jesus wants me to say right now. Well, let's go with the example.
You know what?
Of,
we're
going to
take
right,
a
great.
Quick commercial break, and when we come back, she's going to unveil her number one most challenging.
No, I'm just going to give a regular example.
Just a regular one. Okay, it's Rocktails. If you feel like joining this therapy session, please do. 855-601-7625. My sister's on the show. It feels good.
Bill, where can a guy get another Schlitz around here? And excuse me, Bill.
What's a beautiful girl like you doing in a party like this?
I'm giving it. Anything wrong?
Let myself introduce me. I'm Schlitz.
You're out of Schlitz.
There's just one Schlitz. Yeah, yeah. Nothing else comes near. When you're out of Schlitz.
Just ask.
You're out of beer.
What makes Schlitz irreplaceable? Taste it. This is the most carefully brewed beer in the world. It takes 1,174 careful steps to create that special taste. Real gusto in the great light beer.
If you like it light with a big taste too, there's only one brew that will do when you're out of Schlitz.
Unthinkable.
You're out of beer. Real gusto in the great light beer Schlitz.
The beer that made Milwaukee famous.
This is your wake-up call. Time to reach and go for it all. Fold your
Welcome back to Rock Tales.
Wow. I think this show is evolving right before our viewers and listeners.
Space?
Well, we did a show, I guess, a week ago, right? Or is it 2 weeks ago?
Last week.
Which is, because all the equipment and even the lighting, it's kind of, is the, everyone knows this. It is the best place to test drive new talent.
We launch careers.
Yeah. You get it. Mm-hmm. You get it.
I sure do.
You sure do. Yeah. It is Rock Tales. I am here with my lovely sister. Again, with the, it's not eight, so you're not a, octa.
I'm a spider, right? Or no? How many legs do the spiders have?
Maybe a cockroach? Do they have six legs?
I'm a cockroach. This is my new hairdo.
You know what movie I thought it was going to be better?
Nope.
And I watched it. Was that Jennifer Lawrence movie that looked like? Is it called No Problems or something?
Hunger Games?
Mother.
No Hard Feelings.
No. Mm. No Hard Feelings. Did you watch it, Naughty Gotti?
It's in the queue.
So I watched it. My wife fell asleep. My daughter came in and, you know, caught the tail end of it. I thought the trailer made it look way funnier. I thought it was going to be really great. And it was a...
Oh, bummer. I love her. She's an amazing...
She is. She's... Actress.
I'm obsessed with the show on Netflix right now. It's called Glory. It's a Korean thriller. Mm. And I love... First
Do
of all,
you
I
watch
love,
a lot of Korean cinema?
I watch a lot of thrillers, and I watch a lot of foreign thrillers, and I love reading subtitles. And I love pretending like I've traveled, and I'm also solving a crime.
Okay, you know what's weird? You know what's... Sorry.
Tell me.
No, I was going to say, this is very exciting to me, because I was hoping that tonight on Rock Tales, we could actually play a little game, which is called Moon Zappa, What Are You Into Right Now?
Oh, okay. I love this
and
game.
And just cross all kinds of genres and hobbies and activities.
Well, is she into sharing... A disappointing childhood moment. You know, what
we
did
have
we
to
say
clean
before
that up.
The break?
Oh, yeah. I'll just, absolutely. Okay. Something that Gail did that was disappointing to you, but maybe necessarily not disappointing to
I
the
don't.
Rest.
I mean, like, I've just a childhood
this
thing.
This is like
Gail,
an average
Frank,
one. This is an average
friends,
one.
Whoever it is.
No, this is like a pretty basic classic one. When I
but
did,
wait, what are we talking about? Like, what genre is this? Like, what like area of emotional
14.
Distress?
You started by saying you were having fun as a teenager, and I'm going to say... No.
When you were okay.
Okay. So when you're told that,
and then do I get to tell you maybe a comparable if I have one?
Sure.
You say the words and you say it as Gail saying it to her.
Is this like the Electric Company when we're like shh?
Nope.
It.
No. This is the example. I'll give the example and you can unpack it. When you're told that.
Yeah. You're 14. At 14.
And you're told that your song. You didn't write it because improv isn't writing.
Okay, right.
And then you don't see any money from it.
Oh. Mm.
And then you have to go promote it and pretend to the world that you're a happy family.
Okay.
How am I doing so far?
Oh, God.
Similar, okay. But not the same.
Okay. Richard. Just,
yeah, wait.
We should bring Frank into this conversation.
Okay, wait. Okay, hold on.
Yeah.
Did my first TV show.
Yeah.
Right? Mm-hmm. Maybe similar age. It was like, I don't know, Growing Pains or something like that. I was a childhood actor.
Television actor Ahmet Zappa.
Yeah.
Okay, in case you didn't know. And I think it was like 10 grand.
Yeah.
And I was like, it's all the money in the world.
Yeah.
Right?
You're going to buy a house at the top of Laurel Canyon.
Buy a condo on Wilshire.
Yeah. On King's Road.
Yeah. Right?
Yes.
Right?
10 grand in 1987. Fuck yeah. Rick Zappa is ready to fucking go.
I'm Rick rolling the shit out of that. Okay?
You're going to buy Alfie's Soda Pop Club.
Yeah, I am.
And make it your own.
Until
Gail.
You get a bill for every Coke
you've ever had and or your friends have had, and you're informed that Cokes don't grow on trees.
Right. Here's the
thing,
though.
And that's why they invented the Coogan account.
The Coogan law. The Coogan law. But here's here's what I will say. Uh-huh. If you're a parent, you know this, that if you had a tricky time in your own life, that becomes a tricky time in your parenting world. So I'm assuming that somewhere around 14, Gail's needs weren't met. And therefore, when we were 14, she was like, oh, hell no. I've got no tools for this and no skill set for this.
Let me,
this is me at my best giving her a benefit of the doubt.
Do you ever get laser therapy?
I don't know what that means. Is that like fast therapy? Like just like speed dating?
No, no.
Therapy?
So what happens is we say a bad memory or we talk about something like this.
Yeah.
And then we shoot lasers at it.
No, but what I like to do what should have happened.
Okay, yes. But are you willing to have laser therapy?
I'd have laser therapy, but can I
give us laser therapy?
But can I also just say that what I wish would have happened?
Yeah. Well, okay.
Valley Girl comes out. She goes,
hold on.
Oh my God,
we know what happened.
Yeah.
You didn't write the song. Okay. Okay. Right. So we're gonna
improv is not writing.
Improv is not
writing. Ready? We're gonna laser therapy this shit right now. Ready?
Yeah.
Okay. Mm-hmm. You didn't write the song, man. You don't get it. Okay.
Yeah.
And now,
so two other techniques.
And now the outcome is what you wanted.
Right. Well, two other techniques for reclaiming a memory.
Laser therapy.
No, it's that's the same
thing.
Very similar.
Okay.
You would put a wise self in the memory.
Like a Yoda?
Like a Yoda. You'd put Yoda. You'd redo the memory with Yoda.
What does your Yoda look like? Same hair beads and I mean not hair beads, like same.
It could
of
be
braids?
Like you in the movie version of the story. It could be
it's
like.
So you're saying you right now, you put yourself back there in 1980 odd.
Yeah, some people would put
83.
God in. Or for me, it would be like.
Can we invite more people into this therapy conversation?
Sure. For me, it would be like.
Wait, well, hold that thought. Can we go to Frank on? Let's talk to Frank on. Is he online too? Because maybe, you know, you got Frank. Frank,
are
you there?
Are you there? Yes.
Okay, Frank.
Can you hear me?
We're in a deep conversation. We're getting to some therapy, but, you know, it's good that you have a guitar. It might be, you know, bring back some memories. Your name is Frank. Maybe this could be, like, cathartic. You know, maybe. Is this a seance right now? Are you our dad, Frank?
Ah. No, but Moon.
Yeah.
You're looking great.
Thank you.
Wow, he's getting all fucking horny with you.
Yeah.
What
are you wearing?
Don't get gross, dude.
fuck.
No,
you're looking great.
You should have her on more often. And
oh, his fucking pants are off right now.
Yeah, this is classic, Frank.
Whoa. No. No. No, 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 no.
That's his boner talking to you through music. Hey, I'm just
taking it like courtship. It's sweet.
Are you?
I was the slide guy who called in a while back. I just want to say on the comment on the Satan ethics.
Oh yeah.
You know, just because you believe in those are all good things, but it doesn't make you a Satanist.
That's true.
And then my second, so I just agree with you on that. I agree with you on that. And then my only question was, as you guys when you were growing up. It must have been really cute, and I can only imagine the fights and stuff that you must have had and arguments.
The cute part was really
If you would share just maybe one or those, but then also on the other side, share the greatest moments you had as a family growing up together. And that's all I have to say.
Okay, well, Frank, thank you so much for calling in, and I'm going to try to understand. Wait, you're going to drink Moon's drink? Because it's that good. Captain Cocktail crushed it, right?
With I'm just going to take a little bit.
Well, let me just finish. Okay, I'm going to get to his
request.
He had
a two-parter, right?
So, but first I want to just say, when I like to go back to the memory, what I wish would have happened, the way you might handle it with Halo. If, for example, Halo was just making you laugh, it was recorded, and then the world loved it.
Right.
You wouldn't say, you didn't write that.
Right.
This money isn't yours.
Right.
Right? That would be a weird thing to say.
Right. Shoot that down.
Laser.
Yeah, right.
You would say, wow, this is a surprise. And let's, where would you like to take this dream?
Case in point.
Yeah.
My philosophy.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. That was cool.
Mm-hmm.
So I had to go to a school function for my daughter this morning. Got up at 6 a.m. and even with Naughty Gotti, we were fortunate enough that actually both of our kids go to the same school. Anyways, too much information. So we're there, and every other phrase out of my mouth is like, "Hey man, my job as the dad is to make sure that anything my daughter wants, that's my point of view, right? I'm going to try to make it happen. I'm going to be totally supportive, right?"
And I would say that that is the best thing that's come out of this family.
Right.
Having not had that as a family, we all are committed to being like that, I think, in our own families.
Yeah.
It seems like.
Why did you play me out music? Are you trying to wrap this up for some reason?
No.
The other thing.
Music bad, man.
Because I'm liking where this
is
going.
Did have Joe Elliott from Def Leppard on the show a long time ago, for real. And he did say that Frank called him up at the Mimazon Hotel.
Yeah.
On the Pyromania tour, their first time in Los Angeles.
Yeah.
Literally called him at the pool. Concierge brought the phone over. And he said, "Hey, this is Frank Zappa. I would like you to get me backstage passes for my son and daughter for your big concert at the Forum tonight." And at first, Joe Elliott didn't believe that it was him.
And hung up on him.
And then he called back.
Yeah.
Because he wanted you and your other brother to go to the show.
Do you remember this at all?
Yeah, that was a great show.
Well, there's a good memory.
Yeah.
I didn't know that part of it happened.
Call the pool.
I feel like there's a lot of behind the scenes shit that we weren't kind of like privy to.
Yeah.
And it was like a...
Both good and bad.
Yeah, but you didn't get either the good or the bad.
Mm-hmm.
And it was like a wall of like... kind of not a lot of
information.
Yeah.
Yeah. But I viewed the family like it was the kids and then the adults. And I, as the oldest, I felt like I was like, "I'm going to help us cross this desert and we're going to make it out alive, everybody."
You're
and
Moses.
That's how I was living.
Are you California Moses?
Yeah, I'm CA Moses.
CA Moses.
Yeah. That's my alter ego.
Cam.
Yep.
Mm-hmm. CA Moses.
Tonight it is.
Yeah. Okay. Well, that makes sense to me.
Mm-hmm.
It is interesting to reflect back on generationally, right? So you having your relationship with our parents and coming into, like whatever you were in, like in your interests, mm-hmm. your issues, so different than mine.
Correct.
Being female or male.
Right, because we were raised in a patriarchy, and so that's different for girls.
Do you mean, how
don't
would you...
Don't you know that it's different for girls?
So,
I'm breaking up.
Should we laser that, Tricky Dicky? This is laser therapy. You're not kind of on the ball with the laser therapy. He's not listening.
Okay. But Gail always would say, when you did something she didn't enjoy, she'd say, "You're just like..."
Your father.
No, your sister Moon.
Oh. Oh yeah, that was
good.
That's fucking... But by the way, we left out of not even. Like for me, I was like,
that's a good thing.
Like my thought process is like,
yeah.
You mean addresses it directly? Oh, doesn't like just not go along with the program?
There is something about the you and Diva too of like, and maybe just women in general, right? I kind of think, well, I want to say women in general. I will say about my, what I've witnessed and you guys as champions of the female, you guys are like Vikings. You're like,
yes, that's exactly right.
Right.
I'm a female Viking.
And I do feel like that was kind of ingrained, Uhtred. Certainly into my head. Like, so for me,
Uhtred, son of Uhtred. Yes. Go on.
Right. For me, that's what I'm so grateful. I married like someone who's not to be trifled with. I have like a lion witch, a lioness. Do not mess with her. Mm-hmm. Right. And I have to say that I had to go to therapy to see and understand like that what our mother's experiences were, right? That what I thought I wanted, right, was I made some mistakes,
right?
Yeah.
And I had you as an example. I had so many other, you know, examples, mm-hmm. crazy examples.
Yeah.
Right? Do you feel like that it's a long journey?
That we all dated Gail and we also all dated Frank? Yes, that's what happens families, right? Didn't you all date your parents?
Wait, did you date Gail and Frank or did you also date Gail and
I dated Gail briefly that you guys didn't know about.
But like legit,
in the late
right?
90s, like 98, 99, you didn't know. She and I used to go do karaoke at the Brass Monkey alone on a Wednesday afternoon.
I found this out.
3 o'clock, happy hour. I'm like, she's like, "Where's the best happy hour in town?" I'm like, "Gail would go to Casa Vega."
What are you talking about? Yeah, Gail. I did. We did. We were raised to never drink. People were fired if they did drugs or drank.
Right.
And one day I walked into Casa Vega and our mother was sitting at the bar drinking and I was in my possibly late 20s and
because
I was like,
she had a crush on
the bartender.
Who? Okay, so imagine.
No.
You're being driven.
Information.
Or picked up to maybe, what was the guitar place next to 31 Flavors in Studio City? Like Center Guitar or something like that?
Guitar Center.
No. Like next to Pier 1. It wasn't Guitar Center. Guitar something.
I don't remember. But go on.
So I think we stopped off there or because there was the guitar place. I think it was Center Guitar. Then there's Buddy Brown's. I really wanted to go into Buddy Brown's. Right?
The toy store.
And you know
the best toy store ever that ever existed ever. Go on.
But you know, do you know the connection with Frank and Buddy Brown's?
No.
do you know this song?
Yes.
Bobby Brown?
Yeah.
Do you know that it's
about Buddy?
It's really Buddy Brown?
Are you sure?
I am HIV positive.
Are you sure this isn't about the guy across the street at the shoe store?
Irwin's Bootery is not, hey there, people. I'm Irwin's Bootery. It's, okay. Wait, hold on.
You got to get back to Gail's crush.
I have to rope you in. Get back to the story.
Story A.
A 1975 Rolls Royce Silver Shadow. Okay.
Black.
Okay.
With the hood ornament turned facing the driver.
Right. Okay, and the weird black leather poodle dog in the back.
And the license plate was Redunzel, which was his nickname for Gail.
Mm-hmm. A redundant Rapunzel.
Exactly.
Okay.
Go
this
on.
This is like so granular, weird. Okay, so she's there, and I want to go in the toy store, but she's like, I don't know. I think maybe we'll get some ice cream. And then who drives up? And she's like, oh my God. Like literally.
Marlon Brando.
Fucking Marlon Brando.
His elbow.
Wait, so what?
She was obsessed with, she spotted his elbow, and then that was what she told me, that she could recognize Marlon Brando.
And then she sharted her gine what happened? Yeah. I don't understand. Do you say shart gine?
What does this have to do with Casa Vega? You think she was trying to be there in case he showed up at Casa Vega?
I fucking know, because I asked her, that's why she would go there, because he freaked
trolling him. For Marlon Brando at Casa Vega.
Yeah, Brando dong. That's what she was hoping to get, trying to wrangle that down.
Once Upon a Time in Hollywood story. But that's why she liked Casa Vega. That's your truth. That might not necessarily be Moon's truth. That's why it's interesting that we have this sibling conversation.
But wait,
right, information.
Why did you
puzzle
think
pieces.
Irwin's Bootery?
I don't know.
I don't know.
Maybe let's call a lawyer about it.
No. Hey, as we wrap things up here on Rock, as we wrap things up on Rock Tales, can we bring it back in the present day? Can we find out
bring it
back? Can we find out what's happening in this person's life right now?
Can
we ask?
I'll tell you
what this person is into, what music Moon Zappa is listening to now.
You're always trying to make Rock Tales actually work. And I appreciate
that. I know, but that's, you know, we try.
All right, five bands you actually like.
Well, I'm really into this. I have to look it up because I make myself playlists.
What's the Green Room guy that you play outside?
Yeah, I know. I'm just trying to find him. I think his name is John Grant, and the album is called something Green Ghosts or something. Pale Green Ghosts.
Yeah, she played that. We blasted it outside.
I love that.
Can I say that felt like you said that was your running in the woods song?
Yeah, or if I'm driving on back roads.
John Grant? That's the person?
There it is. Yeah.
I'm not familiar with John. Where's John Grant from?
I don't know, but I love him.
Wait till you hear his vocals. You know, handsome British guy. Do you know this guy? Oh, handsome British guy knows him.
It's a little OMD right now. Is it going to change from OMD to something else?
He's Danish. He has a kind of weird singing voice. You know, I guess we were listening to Ghost upstairs. Back then, you can't hear what we're listening to right now.
Oh yeah,
that's good. Moon likes the melodies this day.
This is very Depeche-y. It's very Modi.
Actually, Captain Cocktail, you would dig this too. You really would. Go. Who else?
I love Chet Baker. Anything by Chet Baker.
Chet Faker?
The fake Chet Baker.
He's not. He's that's nothing like.
So
it,
he's the fake Chet Baker.
That's
weird.
That's
Chet Fet Faker. Shaker.
Fet
Shaker.
Faker.
Chet Faker.
Chet and Faker.
He also goes. What's his real name?
This is Chet Faker.
I'm in heaven.
Tell me things that you've done.
Really?
Yeah. This makes me want to roller skate backwards.
Is this the guy that like has that weird wig and wears the cowboy hat and the big suits or something?
No, I don't know who that is, but tell me more.
That's like David Byrne.
This is number two. We're making a live Moon Zapper playlist, by the way. Not to label it or put it in a box.
So she played me some of this.
Yeah.
And then I think I tried to, I was feeling your vibe.
Yeah.
And was I right? Because recommended.
Yeah.
Right?
I'd add that
Hayley
to
Williams,
yes,
Simmer.
Excellent.
The second you were like kind of saying this, I'm like, oh, I raise you.
Yeah.
Her solo record.
Yep.
Captain Cocktail, you're leaving. I love you. Bye, Captain Cocktail.
Bye, Steve.
Thank you.
Bye.
So this track, right? You're vibing this, right?
I love this.
Do you know this track?
This is Hayley Williams.
Her first solo record, I think. And this, honestly, driving down Olympic, tears. Especially the second verse, when she talks about like the mother energy protecting your child.
What part of Olympic are you on?
Like right Century City.
Oh, okay.
Whatever, like right there on
passing the Ralph.
Century Park East.
Yeah.
When the second verse kicks in there. Yeah.
Rage.
Oh, that's fucking awesome.
Is a quiet thing.
Yeah, I love this. I love her.
Okay. That's number three. What do we got next? What's number four? You're adding to the playlist.
Yeah, I love Glass Animals.
Glass Animals.
Mm-hmm. That sounds weird. Do you know, hey, Tricky, not Tricky Dicky, you're over here. I'm drunk. Handsome British guy. Do you know the Glass Animals? You do?
He says yes.
Where are they from?
The UK.
They're from the UK.
Mm-hmm. Glass Animals.
Moon, I'm seeing you, by the way, on the lighting on you. You look very pretty.
Thank you.
And you have the background. Lighting is good, guys. I like the purple. I'm noticing it for the first time. I like the purple bricks.
This is Glass Animals. What's this song called?
Heat Waves, man.
Heat Waves.
You don't know this song?
No, I listen to these.
This all sounds kind of like the same, right? Like we're getting onto the...
Yeah, this is all me. I love it.
I think we have the same resting speed.
Oh, yeah.
Did we talk about this?
This is like my groove. This is my just like, I coast. Like I this is like my flow tempo.
Do you want to tell me, I know musically it might not be the same. Play Gordon Lightfoot, Sundown. Because this is me.
You want to know my resting speed?
Uh-huh. You tell me if you got the same vibe.
When the great majestic mountains rising up the morning sun.
Wait for it. Mm-hmm. Wait for the groove to kick in. Yeah. See, this is me.
Yeah. Okay.
Can you feel? Are we on the?
We're really close. We're really with like a
I can see you like now in your bedroom dress.
And then he comes in
a room where you do what you confess.
He's singing in Canadian right
Sundown,
now. So it's hard to understand.
If I find you've been creeping around my back
it's slight. It's a little slower.
It's hard to understand.
The belly
Canadian.
Softens.
Yeah. What?
And then you're just like. Yeah, I got it.
For Canadians, or are you just
saying? No, I'm just saying in terms of like the tempo thing, and mm-hmm. that is the best way to get to know somebody is through tempo, through dancing.
Do you know the song that reminds me of Moon more than any song in the planet?
Oh, I'd like to hear.
Well,
this.
Yeah, I'd like to know this too.
Paranoid Android by Radiohead.
There's no Radiohead I don't like. I literally that have
play
so
play
much
that track. Oof. Does it make you want to move this particular song? And why do you have that connection?
She loved it.
Did we see them in Santa Barbara together?
No, I did not go to Santa Barbara. This reminds me of her house.
If this is her a product, house. This is Wishbone Salad Dressing.
What?
Yeah.
Wow.
Call on. Let me hear a little
what
more.
What about Suspirium, like his solo stuff?
All right, let's play Suspirium, the solo stuff. I'll tell you what kind of a product it is. That's Wishbone Salad Dressing. What's
give it to me. Suspirium.
I love this game, by the way. This is a new game. What product is this song? Let's see.
Nothing's happening right now.
It could.
We stand open.
No, this. Do you want to hear the better version of this song? Can you play?
There isn't one.
No. I'll tell you. I'll tell you.
Is it Led Zeppelin? Because I'll do all Led Zeppelin.
No, I'll tell you what the better version of that song is.
Go ahead.
Play Travis. Name me some Travis songs. I gotta remember.
Sing.
That.
Why does it always rain on me?
No.
Why does it always rain on me?
No. Like
Hit Me Baby. Their version of Hit Me Baby.
No. Give me a list. Tricky Dicky. What are the Travis
the hits.
Songs?
You just
give me a list.
What about Fiona Apple?
What's that?
What'd you say? Fear.
No. Keep going.
Jesus Christ, man.
Oh, this is it? I'm having so much fun. Okay, give me another track, Moon. I'll tell you what product it is.
Fiona Apple. How about...
Which one? How good
let's
is her cover?
Let's do Heavy Balloon or...
Heavy Balloon? Who
Heavy
the fuck
Balloon.
Heavy Balloon?
Heavy.
Heavy Balloon.
Okay.
This one kills me.
Is this the name of the song? Or
Heavy Balloon.
Or it actually does that to you
emotionally? This is pure fucking groundswell fire... Roots, volcanic, get it.
People like us, we play.
Okay, you're spider lady right now.
Keep it up to keep the devil at bay, but it always falls way too soon.
Yeah, that's pretty, she's Satan dancing.
People like us, we play with a heavy balloon.
Okay, this is Fiona Apple.
Wait, you didn't get it. But it always falls way too soon. Here it comes. People like us, we play. You're gonna need to make it a little louder, though.
Okay,
we keep it up to keep the devil at bay, but it always falls way too soon.
Yeah, exactly.
I spread like strawberries.
I spread like strawberries.
I climb like peas and beans.
I climb like peas and beans.
So long.
That's right.
That I'm busting at the seams. I spread like strawberries.
Is this not Fiona like Apple just under a different name?
I've been sucking it in
this
so
is
long.
Apple.
Oh, this is awesome.
Yeah.
In the middle of the day, it's like
I
a
love this.
The Sahara wanna stare me down.
Yeah.
Okay.
This whole album is Chef's Kiss.
Is this a new record that I don't...
This is the last one.
What
the latest
that,
one. Yeah.
Did that come out like in the last couple of years?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. You've been busy buying estates.
Because Tidal was the last record that... What was that? Is that
that's,
you fishing?
No, he
no,
has
it's
been.
It's good.
He
I
has
know,
been doing
was,
that.
I thought that was a big sisterly kind of thing.
No,
it's good.
I think it's cool.
Yeah, I think
it.
It's cool too.
Yeah.
No one knows.
It came out bitchy, but it, I didn't
way,
mean it. Bitchy.
By the way, no one knows I'm doing that. So like, it, like.
Oh,
this
sorry.
Like,
was that not supposed to say?
Yeah, well, it came out now. So,
oh, my God, that's horrible. Erase it. Edit it. Can you edit it?
It's live.
Sorry, I'm proud of you for it.
Thank you. Okay. This has been fun.
I didn't know it was a secret.
Thanks for ruining.
This is Frank
show.
Zappa. I would like 2 tickets for my children.
Can we laser my
for
fuck
Moon
up? Sorry.
And Dweezil.
I didn't know.
That.
I didn't know it was.
No,
you guys
it,
are
it
playing the
form
tonight.
Fuck up I just don't. It's not a fuck up at all. I just don't talk about really what I kind of do in my real life, other than
what?
Yeah.
Oh, are you shy?
This has been another episode of Rock Tales. Join us next week.
Are you gonna? By the way, are you gonna do your own like show roundtable kind of situation? You know, you can come here, whatever.
Well, sweet.
It's all for you. It's all for you. Okay.
This rock and roll tale.
Rocktail. See you in 2 weeks. In 2 weeks.
Look what you have done.
Unless we're gonna do a late.
We're going back to Nashville.
I've got
we're in Nashville.
Oh, wait. You guys are gone next week?
Going back sorry. To Nashville next week.
Oh, fuck. Do I have to go visit my mom then?
Yeah, you should. All right. See you next. See you in 2 weeks.
Bye. I love you. Thank you.
I love you. Thank you for having me. Love you, too. Love you, too.